I'm Tom Hardy and you're watching the Venom Vlog.
My man here.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog. This is episode 377, and today we got some actual interesting news about Venom 2, because obviously we have a lot of us been waiting. It wasn't clear that Ruben Fleischer was going to come back and direct the sequel, even though he did a great job with the first one. I think he did a great job setting up the world, but I'm not against a new director coming in either. I like Ruben a lot. I thought he was awesome. I know he went off to do Zombieland 2, and then I think he has a new show that he executive produced coming up with Colby Smulders, who plays Maria Hill in the MCU movies. She's the star of it, and I think it's called Stumptown or something like that, based on a comic book. So he's busy. He's working on stuff, and that's great. So with him busy, obviously Sony has a hit movie franchise, started here, and they need it to continue. And so they've been meeting with a lot of directors. I've been hearing that, from a couple different people saying that they are meeting with directors. And I don't actually listen to a ton of stuff that comes to me like that, because I don't really know where some of that information comes from. So I kind of just sit on it and just go, all right, well, maybe one day when a publication like Hollywood Reporter or someone like Variety or someone reports on it who kind of has their finger on the pulse of agents and actors and people who are going to meetings and stuff, they get wind of it because there's people that work at those studios that kind of leak that information to these sources, to the Hollywood Reporter, to try to get the news out there to see what the internet thinks about it. So it's kind of part of a system. So I kind of trust that system. And when things come from a source within that system, I kind of trust it a little bit more. People like Manabyte and some of those other people out there that are just kind of fans who may have a source or two or three, for all I know, I still take everything they say with a grain of salt, and I really don't trust hardly anything they say, because I feel a lot of times they're just trying to make educated guesses. And then I feel like they have sources sometimes, but other times they're just trying to make educated guesses. And sometimes they're right, sometimes they're wrong. But they're more of a scoop business. And scoop to me isn't that's not a type of news that I try to, go after. I try to wait for things to be at least a little bit further in with the machine that is the Hollywood system. So this kind of made, kind of turned my eye to it. A lot of you guys on Twitter, and I thank all of you for doing this, you were tagging me in this. I was at work. I had no idea that this news came out. And on my breaks even, I had a lot of stuff I had to do. So I couldn't dedicate any time to my phone today while I was at work for the whole 9-10 hours that I was there. So luckily, I took a lunch and I saw a bunch of tags. I had a number of of notifications of my Twitter, and I was like, all right, let's check and see what Twitter's saying. And I saw all you guys posting this stuff, and I was like, wow, okay. So I spent 2 or 3 minutes talking to you guys about it, and I am on board. Andy Serkis, phenomenal actor, played Gollum, just did an adaptation of The Jungle Book, I think, does really great work with motion capture and things like that. Apparently, he's one of the directors that met with Sony, and he's one of the most recent directors, according to this, that met with Sony. So Andy Serkis is in the mix to tackle Sony's Venom sequel, The Hollywood Reporter has learned. But Serkis, who is known for critically acclaimed and beloved work in motion capture space, which I just said, as well as a villain, as Ulysses Claw in Black Panther and Captain America, Civil War, Winter Soldier, or Age of Ultron. He is up for being a part of Venom 2, but not as an actor, as a director, which is crazy because I think he'd actually make a good Carnage now that I think about it. But we already got Woody Harrelson, I guess, on board. We'll see. I mean, I don't know if Woody, he said in an interview that, he's a small part in this movie and he'll be a bigger part if there's a second one. So maybe Woody will still come back. But Andy Serkis, man, put yourself in this movie as somebody. I don't care, man, anybody, because you're awesome. So the Ruben Fleischer-helmed 2018 movie is not returning. Serkis flew to Los Angeles for a meeting set by Sony brass earlier this week. He is one of several filmmakers in the mix, sources say, as Sony carefully weighs who will direct the follow-up to a movie that made $856 million at the global box office off a $100 million budget. That is something else right there. Nobody expected it to do that well. To near that close to $1 billion is impressive. So, of course, they have a big franchise on their hands here, and they don't want to screw it up, so they're being very careful who they choose. But I, for one, I don't know who else is on the list of directors they're meeting with, but I really, this piqued my interest, because this is kind of unorthodox. I wouldn't have figured this would be a possibility. And I think Andy Serkis could do a really good job. I think he would help bring out more of the humanity in some of the characters. And even maybe, you know, be more emotional with the symbiote and tell a really strong story there. And then also the Carnage stuff, like, you know, like how awful his history is, his past, killing his, like, you know, grandma's dog and then kicking her, I think, down the stairs and, you know, being just a complete monster from the get-go and then becoming Carnage on top of that. Cletus Cassidy alone would scare any average person. You throw a symbiote on him and make him, you know, even more powerful, he's even 10 times worse. So I would love to see someone like Serkis, if not Serkis, someone like him to tackle it. But man, if anyone at Sony's watching this or if Andy Serkis is watching this, I, for one, am 100% on board with this decision. If they announced this and they said, hey, he's on board, we're going to spend the next 3-4 months in pre-production, and we're actually going to start rolling cameras in November in Atlanta, like we've been hearing rumors about. Atlanta Filming had mentioned that, and we used him as, he, even though he says don't use him as a source, but we did kind of a little bit in our first season when we were getting early movie news, and he got a lot of stuff right because he's right there on the set, you know, when they're filming. And he's taking pictures and trying to get shots and stuff. And he's an awesome dude. So I'll put a link to his Twitter account down below. And I'll put a link to this article down below too. So make sure you follow him, but also check out this article and read everything that it has to say. It's not much more than what I read there, but it still has a little bit more information that you guys might want to know. And I don't want to read the whole thing because I want to kind of direct traffic to this for them bringing this news to us and for all of you guys who brought the news. So thank you for this. This is kind of, you know, not our first bit of news for Venom 2, because we already knew Kelly Marcel was coming back to write it. She was, you know, for those who don't know, in the first, you know, when they were filming Venom, I guess Tom Hardy had a differences about the script and kind of, you know, walked off set one day and was like, no, I need a better writer. I need a better script. I can't say some of these words. And he hired Kelly Marcel to come in, and she was there on set to like help punch up stuff and come up with new scenes and new pages for Tom Hardy and stuff. So, awesome stuff. I'm glad she's coming back. And apparently she's going to be the sole writer, at least for the first draft of this. Who knows, they might bring someone else in to punch it up too. But knowing that, you know, is pretty good. And I know that'll make Tom Hardy feel really well, you know, knowing that at least the first draft will probably start off a lot stronger, as opposed to her coming in and fixing, you know, a messy script. You know, she'll start off with hopefully a really solid script. So I'm all for this. All this sounds really neat. And obviously if Andy Serkis comes in, he might have some ideas that he'll interject into the storyline as well. But I want to hear what you guys think. Sound off down below, because obviously I'm super excited about this. I don't know. I mean, nothing's official, obviously. He just had a meeting with them. So did other directors, as they say. And like I said, I tend to believe that because that's kind of how the system works in Hollywood. When people go meet somewhere, someone at that studio leaks it to Hollywood Reporter. They work with PR people. It's a whole thing. But if watch Entourage. They do it a lot in Entourage. I thought this was exciting news. And I want to know what you guys think. Do you think Andy Serkis could be a really good director for Venom 2? If you do, let me know down below. And if you don't, who would you like to see direct Venom 2? Let me know in the comments, and we'll continue our conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you all in the future. Peace.